Hi, I'm Jared. Welcome to Fun Science Demos. And I'm standing up today because we're going to be launching balloon rockets, starting here and sending them soaring all the way across our classroom. Now, in a previous video, we showed you all of our design ideas for a special two-stage rocket. And we want to use our fishing line to see if we can compare how far a single-stage balloon rocket will travel compared to our special two-stage design rocket ideas. Now here at Fun Science Demos, we recommend using a clear fishing line, but that makes it really hard for the camera to see. So we use the special fly fishing line that's neon yellow and much easier to see. Now we stretch this line across our classroom. This classroom is about 25 feet or 8 meters long or wide. If we had a bigger classroom, we could make it a longer run. Now remember what makes our rockets work. A force is a push or a pull, and we have air inside the balloon that is going to push against the air outside the balloon, sending the balloon forward. So how do we start this? Well, we put a little tab of tape because our balloon is long and we don't want to put it right against the wall. We want to have enough space, especially for our two-stage rocket, to have enough space to fit. I have a straw on our line with a little piece of tape, and all we do, tape our balloon to our straw. It now slides. And when I let go of the balloon, our rocket should go forward. So we moved our camera so you can get a good idea of how far our single stage or one stage rocket's going to travel. Here we go. We're clear for takeoff, 3, 2, 1. And it did not quite go the full length of our line. So in our other videos, we showed you how to make a two-stage rocket. We decided to go with our clear cup for our two-stage rocket design. And we're going to see if we can get our two-stage rocket to fly further down our fishing line. So we're going to attach our rocket to our straw the same way we did with our single-stage rocket. Now, my two-stage rocket is ready for takeoff. We're going to move the camera again so we can see if we can get our two-stage rocket to go further than our single-stage rocket. We're ready to test our two-stage rocket. Launch in 3, 2, 1. First stage away. Yes!
3, 2, 1. First stage away.
So our two-stage rocket made it all the way to the end of our fishing line. It looks like we're going to need a longer fishing line if we wanted to get an accurate measurement and collect that data to see how far our two-stage rocket could actually go. But I wanted to try our second design for a two-stage rocket using only rubber bands. We're going to move the camera again and see how this design works. Our rubber band two-stage rocket is ready for launch in 3, 2, 1.
3, 2, 1.
So our rubber band two-stage rocket did make it further than the single-stage rocket, but we had some issues with that one. It looked like the green balloon held on longer, but it also looks like the green balloon did not come away cleanly from the rocket. It looks like the rubber bands were holding the green balloon up and holding back the blue balloon of our two-stage rocket. Something as simple as flying our rockets on this fishing line can make you a scientist. Remember, scientists don't just want to gather data and collect data. They want to compare data to see which rocket is better. I could use a stopwatch to see which rocket flew the fastest. I could use a tape measure to measure which rocket flew the longest, and that would make me a scientist. Which rocket is better? Now remember that science and engineering is all about trying new things to see if I can make something work better. What if I use different shaped balloons? What if I tried making a three-stage rocket? Well, I think I'd need a lot longer fishing line. If you want to learn more about science and engineering, check out our YouTube channel. 3, 2, 1. You should have seen that launch.